Welcome to CoreCon today for January 2nd, 2019. This is the show where I break down some of the biggest stories happening in the world of core cutting right now and give you my opinion on them. Now, this is my opinion. If you want to learn more about these stories, check out the show notes at the bottom in the show notes down below. There I'll have a link to each story so you can read about them for yourself and come up with your own opinions. I'd love to hear from you. Now, if you're new here, do me a favor, hit that subscribe button, hit that thumbs up. I would really appreciate it. Lets YouTube know you enjoy what we do here, and hopefully we can help you break free from the high cost of cable TV, but still watch the shows you enjoy. Well, first, I hope everybody had a fantastic new year. It's our first recorded show of 2020. We had one yesterday, but it was pre-recorded. And a little heads up, I'm traveling for a wedding for a couple days, so bear with me as the audio and video may not be the best, but very soon we'll be at CES next week, and we'll be back to hopefully some great quality here. So let's get into it because a lot is happening right now. Let's take a look at some of the biggest stories happening in the world of core cutting, starting off with a few deals. Amazon's $24.99 Fire TV Stick 4K was supposed to end the sale on New Year's Eve. The terms of service still says the deal ended on New Year's Eve, but it's still available, and we test out, and promo code still works. So if you missed out and you want to get a Fire TV Stick 4K for about half off for $24.99, check out the show notes down below for a post on how to do that. All right, robocalls have been a big issue. I get a ton of them. You probably get a ton of robocalls that you don't want. Car insurance, bank accounts you don't have, and more. There's a new bill that's been signed by the president, passed through the House, passed through the Senate, now signed into law that will allow the FCC to crack down on illegal robocalls, give new tools to phone carriers to block robocalls, and crack down this. So why is this important for core cutting? We've actually seen a trend of telemarketing scams targeting Roku owners, Netflix subscribers, and more. As with all things, when you get bigger and bigger, scammers start paying attention to you. And now it seems that, at least according to this, they're going to make a bigger effort to try to crack down on them, which I love. You've probably heard of the, for example, Roku activation scams. That's one scam targeting core cutters where they try to trick you into thinking you need to pay a monthly fee because you Googled Roku activation, ended up on a site that wasn't Roku's, and suddenly they're asking for $100 to activate your Roku. We've seen a lot of email spam trying to steal your information, and we've even heard of a few examples of robocalls pretend to be Netflix, for example, saying, hey, we need you to reset your username and password, or your payment was declined. We need a credit card to go renew that, for example. So keep that all in mind. I hope this does work. None of this happens overnight. You're not going to, just because this law was passed into reality, you're not going to suddenly see robocalls decrease, but it should help, hopefully, in the future going forward. All right, and let me know. Have you ever received any of those spam emails pretend to be Netflix or a robocall pretend to be Roku or somebody? Let me know what your story is. All right. Jumping over to the Cordy Awards. So one of the last awards we're handing out is for the best smart TV OS based on you, the reader and viewers here voting earlier in December about what you said were the best core cutting devices and services. Overwhelmingly, over half of our readers said Roku TVs was the best OS for a smart TV. Now, we're looking at the OS, not necessarily the TV itself, but over half of them said Roku. Amazon Fire TV was very popular. Samsung was very popular, too. LG and more. Vizio had a lot of votes. I'd love to know, if you're a Roku TV owner, what do you like about Roku so much that you voted it to be the best OS for a smart TV for core cutters? I'd love to hear from you and why you thought that. If you want to learn more about this, see the full breakdown of all the different OSs, check out the post in the show notes. All right, a lot of news happening with Fubo TV yesterday. And I may have to back up first, but Fubo TV has lost access to FX, FX Movies, and National Geographic. They also lost the Fox Regional Sports Networks, which also includes the YES Network. So last year, Fox sold most of their assets to Disney, which includes like FX, FXX, National Geographic, and more. And part of that is Disney turned around and sold the regional sports networks, mostly to Sinclair. And now it seems that the contracts that FuboTV had has come to an end. Now this means FuboTV needs to go strike a new contract with them, and they weren't able to do that. Now Disney often very notoriously requires, for example, if you want their cable networks, you also have to have their sports networks like ESPN. And according to reports, Sinclair charges a lot for their regional sports networks. So we're going to have to keep a close eye on this, but if you're a FuboTV owner and you woke up, couldn't find your FX, couldn't find your Fox Regional Sports Network, that's because they lost rights to that content. It's very unfortunate. It really does stink, but hopefully this returns. But this is a growing trend, especially with the regional sports networks. When I talk to people in the industry, they say, hey, there's some of the most expensive channels, but they're also some of the least watched channels. And it's really tough for us to justify, hey, we're going to pay a huge premium to get a regional sports network when a vast majority of our viewers don't watch it. Why should I pay so much money per subscriber if the average person isn't viewing it? And ESPN is the other very expensive channel. It's one of the most expensive channels out there. And FuboTV said they don't think it's worth that price. So, love to know what you think about this. Do you like it that FuboTV is trying to hold the line here? Or do you wish they had it? Leave me a comment, let me know. All right, next story up of the day. There's a brand new over-the-air TV network called Circle. This is a country lifestyle music channel in partnership with the Grand Ole Opry out in Nashville. It went live in a bunch of markets yesterday, and they say more are on the way. For now, there's no streaming option, but they say in the spring they'll be launching a streaming service. Now, we'll see what that all costs and entails. But if you haven't rescanned your antenna recently, you probably should do that because there are a lot of channels moving this month. There's a lot of channels launching, with Circle being one of the big ones. So check it out. So if you love country life, if you love country music, you probably want to check out this channel 100% free with your antenna. Good news if you're a past Sling TV subscriber. If you had Sling TV in the past and are currently not subscribed to it, Sling TV emailed out a special invite to past subscribers yesterday on January 1st, offering them free access to Sling TV, Orange and Blue, plus pretty much all the add-ons until January 12th. Now here's the catch. You do have to supply them a payment method. If you don't cancel before the 12th, they will automatically discontinue your automatically continue your subscription and bill you for Sling TV. But if you've been thinking about giving Sling TV a second try, they have a bunch of new channels like Fox News, Fox Business, the Big Ten Network is coming. They have added a free DVR to everybody, and then a paid one if you want additional storage. And they've removed a lot of DVR restrictions that they used to have. So you've been thinking about trying them out, and you were an old subscriber, you dropped them, maybe they didn't have the channel you want, maybe they didn't have the features you want. They want you to come back and give them another try. So check that out. Link in the show notes down below. You need to find it in your email, though, if you want to test this out. And lastly, we updated our big, massive chart. Now, we posted this yesterday, and I've already had to go back this morning and update it because of FuboTV changes and more. But YouTube TV versus Vidgo, Philo, Hulu, Sling, FuboTV, YouTube TV, AT&T TV Now, we break them all down side by side. Now, I know there's a lot of places out there where we say, hey, we'll tell you what you should get. I'm much more in the mindset of, hey, we're just going to give you all the information. I think you're more capable of making a decision. I would highly encourage you to check this list out, even if you've used one of those services that tells you what you should get. Because sometimes I think some of those are a little, they have some dated information, or maybe they prefer one service over the other, where you may actually think, well, yeah, you know, maybe I do have to miss that one channel, but this other service has what I want. And that's what we hope to offer here by giving you all the information, and then you can pick from it. So check them out. Don't be afraid to use those services that will try to recommend you something. But do your own research. Make sure it's up to date because so much changed yesterday. It's hard for me to keep on top of it, and this is what I do for a living. And make sure that, hey, just because maybe there is one channel in my lineup that this doesn't offer, but maybe that's a lot cheaper. Maybe that one offers other things I want. So I highly recommend you check this post out and really consider what's right for you. Well, that's it for today. Sorry my voice is very weak. Picked up a little bit of a cold traveling this week, so hopefully that goes away very quickly. But I'll be back tomorrow with more Cord Cutting Today. Don't forget to check out cordcuttersnews.com because we post so much content over there that never makes it to the YouTube videos because there's more than I could ever cover here. So check that out, cordcuttersnews.com. I'll see you tomorrow. And don't forget, if you're new here, hit that subscribe button, hit that thumbs up. It really does help us. Take care, everybody. I'll see you real soon.